So Nature Medicine receives around 3,000 papers in a year, and we tend to send, I think, around 500 of those out to review, which is about 15%. Of those, we accept possibly about a third of those. So we have a 95% reject rate, but it's quite a high volume of papers, and there's only so many pages we have in the journal, unfortunately. So the first thing that we do is read the paper and assess whether or not it's a good fit for the journal, so whether it fits it within our scope and with the strategic interests of the types of papers that we're interested in publishing in Nature Medicine. After that, we tend to go in and look for novelty, and then we'll be looking to see if there is scientific rigor. And we look at the methods, whether or not it's an appropriate experimental design, and whether or not the conclusions support the data. That's very important. What we do is we look for reviewers, and we've got very specific criteria for reviewers. Obviously, anyone who you've excluded, we would respect that, and we don't send papers to people who you've asked to not be in the process. We tend to use a mixture of reviewers who we're quite familiar with, who we trust and we know their work very well, as well as reviewers who are new to the journal, who we might be interested in having involved in the journal. Once a paper has been out to review and we have all of the comments back, we then discuss every paper as a team together, along with the reviews, and make our editorial decision on whether or not we'd like to move forward with the paper, in which case we would invite a revision or we would send a decision letter to the author, possibly recommending that they submit elsewhere. And then once the revision has been received, we may or may not send it back to reviews. It depends on what the depth of the review was and what the required revision, and whether or not we feel adequately position to assess that. We could send it back to reviewers who are particularly keen to see it or who had particularly difficult points raised to see if they're then satisfied with the new work. And then after that, we would make our second round decision as to whether or not we'd move forward with the paper. Ideally, we'd only like one round of revision, but it is often the case that sometimes multiple iterations of a paper are seen until we get the paper in the best possible shape that it can be for publication. The most important points for a Nature Medicine paper would be something that will make an impact in the clinic, or at least where you can see a clear pathway of translation into the clinic from the work. We no longer publish a lot of really lovely, beautiful mouse studies of knockouts, saying protein X could be a potential therapeutic target for disease Y. What we're interested in seeing is translational work that is much closer to the clinic. The groundwork for the clinical trials, if not the early phase and later stage clinical trials themselves. Novelty is really important as well. So there's a clinical impact isn't always novel. But also, if there's a story that's quite new and developing, and it's got a lot of novelty, and I think that it's quite disruptive, that can actually also be really interesting for us. I think a manuscript that is very clear in its write-up is very helpful, but that is certainly not the be-all and end-all to whether or not we would move forward with a paper or consider a paper further for review. Oftentimes, a simple paper with a very important concept and conveyed very clearly can be one of the best types of papers that I see. I think authors should think about their paper almost like a news story, where you want the headline first, rather than showing, which are important still, to show all of your controls and how you, often the way that we'd like to see the write-up is actually the inverse of the way the story was developed. Because you start small and then you develop into something big as you're researching in the lab, right? Whereas when we read the paper, we want to see the discovery and then all of the supporting evidence that goes with that. Well, it's not that we're celebrities, but I know that when I was a student, I would never talk to editors. They would come to my poster and I would be fairly intimidated by that. But I think that you should always be open to approaching an editor and talking about your story. And generally, I think that we're quite open to that. And, you know, I quite enjoy talking to students and postdocs at their sessions, particularly their poster sessions. And I think that it's fine to ask for feedback. So if we do turn your paper down, it's not often easy for us to give feedback simply because of the volume of papers. But certainly if you've met an editor previously and discussed your work and then submitted it, you may be able to get a couple more points from us after the decision is made.